What's up, guys? Jimmy or Chaos, welcome back. If you get anything from G2A, make sure to tweet at me and let me know. Use promo code Chaos to get cash back. And I want to talk to you guys about something that possibly, if ends up being true, would be something that a lot of people would be happy with. One of the things that I've seen a lot of people complaining about, everybody's happy that we are getting Modern Warfare Remastered. And watching Raven listen to the community and even fix the little things is really, really cool. But one of the things that people have been upset about is the fact that it's tied to Infinite Warfare. They want the choice to get Infinite Warfare or Modern Warfare Remastered or get both. But as you know, the only way that we know of right now is to pre-order or get Infinite Warfare to receive Modern Warfare Remastered. But there may be something in the future that says it could be a standalone game. And once again, this is not confirmed in any way, but I'm going to break it down for you and let me know what you guys think. So, the director for Raven, David Pelles, hope I said that right, did an interview about Modern Warfare Remastered, and he said a few things that will raise your eyebrows. Actually, one thing in particular. And he went on to say, what we announced before today was that we were going to offer 10 maps on launch, and that is true. Everybody knows they're going to give us the 6 remaining maps in the future, I think around December, Christmas time, for free. But now, listen to the wording very carefully. The announcement today is that 6 remaining maps we are actually going to be delivering to anyone who purchases Modern Warfare Remastered, comma, anyone who owns it, or a version of Infinite Warfare that comes with it. They are going to get all 16 maps at no additional cost. Did you guys catch that? He made a specific distinction between people that will own Modern Warfare Remastered as a result of purchasing it, getting it attached to Infinite Warfare, and those who would purchase it on their own. Now, maybe he got his words mixed up, got tongue-tied, I don't know. I highly, highly doubt you see Modern Warfare Remastered as a standalone title at launch. Matter of fact, I would almost guarantee it. It's going to be attached to Infinite Warfare, but at least it leaves the door open for the slight possibility that in the future, people would be able to actually get it as its own title. If it was going to happen, I would assume that it would happen once Infinite Warfare's launched, months down the road, and then if people want the option, they're going to give people the option on stuff down the road to keep things going, to keep sales going. So I can see it actually happening in the future. Do I think it's going to happen at launch? Absolutely not. But you guys, let me know what you think. He did give that conveyance that it could be possible in the future that you could actually get this by itself. I know people want that on launch, but I don't think that's going to happen. I hope you guys have a great day. Source in the description to the article if you guys want to check it out. And on the screen now is the top 10 best gun sounds in COD history. Go check that out, and I'll see you guys later.